Good morning, everyone. Myself, Priyanka Shahane. Our today's guest speaker is Mr. Arpit Yadav. He is currently working as a senior data scientist at INSO Bangalore and having around 11 years of experience in the field of data science. Also, he got many awards and recognitions from reputed organizations like VDGood, HEI, IAECT, for research and corporate training. So you can start with the session.
Hello. Priyanka, ma'am, my voice is clearly audible?
Yes, you are audible.
And my screen is visible?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Shall I start the session then?
Yes.
Ma'am, one request is there. During the session, I will interact with the audience. So ask the audience to be very interactive. Okay. I will not deliver one-sided communication, a webinar. I will interact with the student. Okay.
Yes, sure.
Yes. Okay, ma'am. I'm starting the session. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. A very good morning to all the participants. I welcome all of you on the today's webinar on Data as a New Oil, Unlock True Potential of Data. First of all, I would like to thank AISSMS All India Shri Shivaji Memorial Society and the Department of Artificial Intelligence and Data Science for organizing this wonderful webinar and inviting me as a guest speaker to deliver the session. So before starting the session, I would like to say something. Always remember one thing. Whenever you people have decided to learn any new technology in the market, so first of all, ask the three questions to yourself. What are those three questions? That three questions are, the first question is, what is this technology about and why it is so much famous in the market? The second question is, why multinational companies are using this technology and what are its impact and advantages of the in the society? And the third question is, what skill sets are required to learn this technology? And after upgrading the skill set in this technology, what are the opportunities for me in the market in terms of job or either in terms of startup? So I will be answering all these questions in a very easy way so that you will going to have a look on all the process and you can get benefited. So before starting, I would like to say something about me as well. I have done my bachelor's in electronics and telecommunication engineering and my master's in VLSI design. Currently, I am pursuing my PhD in machine learning. And I have done my post-graduation program in artificial intelligence and machine learning from Texas University, USA. I am having the total 11 years of experience. Parallelly with my main job, I am having the 8 years of experience in skill development training. That means I am passionate to mentor the students in the relevant and recent technologies. I am an international speaker in data science, machine learning, and deep learning technology. I have filed 4 patents till date, out of which 3 Indian patent and 1 Australian patent. I have published 5 plus topmost international journal publications in the field of data science, machine learning, deep learning, and AI. I have published more than 70 plus certifications in the field of data science, machine learning, deep learning, and AI. About my industrial association, currently I am working as a senior data scientist at INSOFE Bangalore. Parallelly, I am associated as a mentor across the world with many organizations in the field of data science, machine learning, and AI. In that, I am working as a guest faculty as a data science and machine learning topic in BITS Pilani. I am also mentoring the certification program in artificial intelligence and machine learning by ENICT Academy, IIT Guwahati. I am a member of curriculum advisory committee in data science at Regenesis Business School, South Africa. I am also associated as an industry mentor in AI/ML at Northern Cap University, Noida. I am also working as adjunct faculty in AI/ML at Dr. D.Y. Patil Institute of Engineering and Management Research, Pune. And I have been appointed as an expert advisor in AI/ML domain at Savitribai Phule Pune University. So this is my industrial association. And apart from that, because of my work, I have been rewarded with some awards. These awards are, I have received the Inspirational Scientist Award on 7th International Scientist Awards on Engineering, Science and Medicine. Then I have received this award as a excellence in research HEI from the Progress Global Award Foundation, and this award I have received from the Padma Shri awardee Dr. Ajay Gupta sir, which motivates me a lot to do something better for the society. Then I have been received the award in Best in Innovation Training and Design Award from the International Association of Educators and Corporate Trainers, IAECT 2020. From the same organization, I have been received the award of Best Corporate Trainer Award. So all these awards and rewards motivates me a lot to do something better for the society. Now let's start our main topic of the discussion, as the data is our new oil of the world. So please remember, student, I have asked the three questions to you in the first slide. So whenever we are learning any new technology, so I have given the overview of the three questions. So that three question, when we are learning the data science technology, will be like this. What is data science technology and why it is so much famous in the market? Why multinational companies are using the data science technology and what are its impact on the society? And the third question is, what are the skill set required to learn the data science? And after upgrading the skill set in the data science, what are the opportunities in the market in terms of job as well as in terms of startup? So I will be addressing all this query in a very quality way. So in the throughout the session, we are going to cover who can learn data science, what is data science and machine learning from company point of view, why data science and machine learning is very famous, how data science is impacting our day-to-day life, why data science is famous from company project point of view, what are its skill sets and components required, what are the job role, tools used in the company, application and the challenges. So this we are going to cover. So let's start the session. So as I said, I am an international speaker. Whenever I am giving my session across the world, so I am getting this first doubt from the participant. Participants are always the two types. One is the working professional and another are the students. Working professional and the student both are having this doubt. Who can learn data science? So working professional is having the doubt that I am from XYZ field and of N years of experience. And the student is having the doubt that I am a fresher student. I am from XYZ branch. I am from mechanical, civil, electrical, textile, or either I'm a BBA, BCom student. So this fresher student is having the doubt that they can learn this technology or not. And after that, there's the second doubt is, what is the right time to learn this technology? So I am having something interesting thing to show you people for giving the answer of this question. What is that interesting thing? That interesting thing is this. Please concentrate on my word. He is Mr. Siddharth Pillai. Siddharth Pillai, a 7th standard student working as a data scientist in Hyderabad. And this is the true news. His interview has been telecasted by so many news channels. Just 7th standard student working as a data scientist. I got shocked when I came to know about him. He is Mr. Tanmay Bakshi, 16-year-old boy. And he is also very famous as an AI researcher in the world. He is a TEDx speaker as well. He is working as an AI researcher in IBM and very famous. Again, I got shocked when I came to know about him. He is Mr. Sarang Sumesh. He is 8-year-old boy. 8-year-old boy and very famous for making the AI robot. His episode has been telecasted in the History News Channel. And he is also youngest TEDx speaker. 8-year-old boy, guys. Can you imagine 8-year-old boy? Then after that, he is Mr. Arham Om Talsania. 6.5-year-old boy. His name has been recorded in Guinness World of Record. For what reason? Because he is the youngest in the world who has cracked the Python Microsoft certification examination. He is the youngest in the world. Okay. So 6.5-year-old boy can done this achievement. Now, instead of asking the doubt to me that who can learn this technology, whether it is possible for us to learn or not, you are having so many doubts in the mind, whether it is possible for us to learn this technology or not. So by giving this example, I want to ask a counter question to all of you. If these small children can learn this technology, then why you people can't learn? So I want an interactive session, guys. Please interact with me right now. Who is elder? You people are elder, or this example which I have given, these are elder. Who is elder in age?
We are elder.
You people are elder. Okay, obviously. So please always think in your mind that if proper guidance is given to you people at proper time, proper resources is given to you people at proper time, proper mentoring is given to you people at proper time, so can't you learn any new technology? Yes. Yeah, can't you learn any new technology, guys?
Yes.
You can learn that technology, obviously. So the thing is that who can learn data science? Actually, data science is such a technology came in the market which can be learned by anyone. Hence, you can observe one very drastic changes in the society that even though MBA colleges are also opening the branches, MBA in data analytics, MBA in business analytics, and so on. Arts students, commerce background students, science students, everyone can learn data science. And what is the right time to learn this technology? We people are already late. Actually, why we are already late? Because nowadays school student are also learning this technology. Okay. Government of India has already given the notification to all the schools. Please apply this technology to the upcoming generation. So nowadays you can imagine school students are learning this technology. So you can imagine that upcoming generation will be a very versatile generation. They will throw you out if you will not learn this. So please give me the answer of this question. You people are from the AI branches, I guess, and you are in the second year, right?
Yes, sir.
What motivates you people to take AI? What fascinated you to take the AI?
Job opportunity.
Oh, job opportunity. Okay. After that?
High salary.
High salary is the one motivation factor. Okay. Then, any new
scope and research and development opportunity.
Okay, research and development and so many things. So this fascinated you people to take the AI branches. Okay, so let's see after choosing these branches, what you are going to do for the society, what you are going to do for the world, and parallelly also you are going to earn so much money. So let's see how you can able to do that. But during the session, we will be focusing on this factor also, why this technology very famous. So in this, why you people want to learn data science? Why to learn data science actually? So the answer is very simple. Every multinational companies in the world or a small scale companies in the world are having the huge databases in their server. So that means data in their databases, I can say they are having the huge data in their databases called server, and from that data they want to make a business. So how they are going to make a business? By solving the problem of demand and supply, that is called as a project. Hence, company has solving the demand and supply on the basis of data available in their server, and they are making the business. Because of this reason, company has declared that data is your new oil and the fuel of 21st century. Data science is an attractive career because it is changing the world, and finally they have declared that data science is the future. So because of this reason, you have to learn data science. And after this, the question should arise in your mind. What is the exact difference between the world called data science, machine learning, deep learning, and AI? So before going ahead, please tell me, guys, these four words, data science, machine learning, deep learning, and artificial intelligence, is the same or different?
Sir, it's different.
So in this case, what is the sequence also we should know, that out of these four words, what should I learn first so that I should get a quality knowledge?
because majority of the public in the market is having the confusion. Many people are telling that is data science, machine learning, deep learning and AI is same. No, it is not the same. It is same under the umbrella of the world called data. But everything is having its own responsibility. So let's have a look what is the exact meaning of data science. You people have gone through this word n number of times in your college academics and either outside of the college. In your mind, can you people tell me what do you mean by data science?
According to you, see, always remember one thing. Here right now, why is not going on. Here discussion is going on. If anyone will give the wrong answer also, it will be appreciated. So don't take it. Discussion mode is just expressing your views. That's it.
Taking a large collection of unsorted data,
okay,
and then processing it and fine-tuning it so that, you know, we can understand what part is more beneficial for doing, like, okay, for achieving a specific target.
Yes, very good. And after that, anyone want to contribute on this answer? Okay, don't worry, I will give the answer. See, you are correct in your point of view, absolutely correct. So let's go step by step. What is data science actually? Data science is nothing but the science of data to make a business. That is making data work for you. This is a definition you will not find in this internet also. This is our experience and we have contributed to this definition. Data science is the science of data to make a business. Now a question should arise in your mind that what is the science of data you are talking about and how we are going to make a business. So let's see, answer is very simple. That, as I said, every company is having the huge data in their database, that is server. That is called as a raw data. Error is there in the data. So what the company professionals are doing, they are converting this raw data into information. Okay, they are converting in raw data into the information with the help of data preprocessing. That is called as science. So when you apply this science on the raw data, okay, what do you mean by science? Science is the combination of language knowledge, mathematics knowledge, algorithm knowledge, and visualization knowledge. That is the science. When you are applying this science to the raw data, that raw data is going to give you hidden information. And from that hidden information, company people are taking the decision, business decision to grow. So that is the data science. It's a science of data to make a business. And I'm having the habit of teaching that every word that is data science, machine learning, deep learning, and AI from their word itself. So in the data science, there are two words, data and science. Divide the data science into two words. Data is separate, science is separate. What do you mean by data? Data is divided into two categories in the world, that is structure and unstructured data. So what do you mean by structured data, guys? Very simple. Structured data means a data which is available in the well-formatted way. For example, Excel sheet. You are a student of AISSMS College. Second year might be AI. So you will be having one class teacher allotted, for example. They are maintaining your all data. And every information available in that Excel sheet will be accurate. Structured data. Then what do you mean by unstructured data? Unstructured data means data available in the form of images, video, audio, and the text. That is unstructured data. According to one survey, it has been said that out of the 100% data which is available in the world, 80% of the data, approximately 80% of the data is unstructured data. That is, data available in the world is more in the form of images, video, audio, and text. Unstructured data. So company is having this data with them. So what the company has to do? Company want to find some information from that, hidden pattern from that. So how they are finding? By applying the scientific methodology called science. When we are applying the science to the world data, okay, with the science means what I am again repeating, combination of language knowledge, mathematics knowledge, algorithm knowledge, and the visualization knowledge. So that data is going to give you hidden information. And from that hidden information, it is going to make a business. Okay, so this is the data science, guys. So finally, this is the main diagram. Raw data is with the company. We are applying this all knowledge of data preprocessing to the raw data. It is going to give the two information, that is either the hidden information or research knowledge. and from both the company is going to make a business. Research knowledge means you can go ahead for the patent analysis and all. So making the data work for you. This is the world of data science, guys. So once this definition is clear to you people, that with the help of data science, we are going to make a business. The second thing should come in your mind that from where the data is coming. From where the data is coming, guys. So for that purpose, we all people are under observation. We all are under observation. How? See, every day you people, and I am also, every day we people are writing the messages in WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, emails, and other platforms. Every day we people are uploading the images in any of the social media. Every day we people are also uploading, might be, videos as well. Okay, in the TikTok, in the Facebook, Instagram, in the YouTube, and other social media.
Every day we people are doing the online activities. Might be we are surfing the net, internet. Okay. You are ordering the food from the Zomato or Swiggy. You are booking the cab from the Ola and Uber. Okay. Or either you can booking the hotels also, OYO. You can doing the online shopping as well with the help of e-commerce website. So you are doing the n number of activities every day. So intentionally and unintentionally, guys, we people are generating the huge volume of data every day. Getting? We people are spending the huge time on the internet, and we are spending the huge volume of data intentionally and unintentionally via any one of the activities. So we all are under observation. Every individual in the world is generating the huge volume of data, even though our parents also. Intentionally and unintentionally, if they don't know this word also, but they are a part of data science world as a data generator. Okay, so this is the case, guys. Okay, now I want to ask the question to all of you. Have you ever experienced this activity? So please tell me yes. That you are having the Amazon app, suppose. Yeah, you have visited one of the product in the Amazon app. And you are in that page of that product in the Amazon app. Now, due to some reason, you didn't able to purchase that product and you have came out of the Amazon app. After 2 and 3 hours, when you are logging into Facebook and other media, so you are finding the same product is highlighted there in the form of advertisement. Have you ever observed this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes.
Because of why they are showing like this to you people, because you are under observation. Your each activities are under observation. So Amazon company is observing you that one of the user has visited their app, and under that app they have visited one product page, but due to XYZ reason that user didn't able to purchase the product. So but Amazon is having that user activity details. Hence, it's now Amazon duty to motivate that user in the other social media also to purchase that product. How? Because they are sending the product in the form of advertisement there. So this is one very simple example I have given to you. Nowadays, political parties are using the data science to win the election. How they are using the election? Let's take an example. Political party, suppose, has given one project to IT company. Please let us know our image in the public. Okay. Suppose let's talk about Pune city. You are all from Pune? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay, so your college is in Pune?
Yes,
here. Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's take a reference of Pune city. Suppose in Pune there is one political party. They have given one project to one IT company of Pune. Please let us know about our image of the political party in the public, so that IT company has taken the project. What that IT company will do, that IT company will make one post related to that political party leader, their thought and everything. They will make one post. They will send this post to the political party for the permission. Political party has given the green signal, okay, you can publish this post now. Now after getting the permission, that IT company has posted the post in Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and here and there. Now, you are in the Pune city. I am from Nagpur, so I am in Nagpur. So it depends on that IT company filter to whom this post can be viewed in the entire India or entire world or only to the Pune city or anything. So let's take an example that they have selected all while posting. So that post will viral across the world. Now we as a public, that post will come in our Facebook time feed. Now, as a user, I am having the 4 to 5 activities. What I will do, either I will ignore the post first activity. Second, either I will view that post, second activity. Third, I will view the post and I will like the post. Then either I can share the post, either I can comment on the post. So whatever you are going to do, you are going to generate a data, and that data will be collected by that respective IT company. So let's imagine the public has reacted to that post. 100% data came with that IT company. Now that IT company will do the analysis of that post. That out of 100% with the data which we have received, either like, share and comment, they came to know after analysis, 80% of the public has given the positive opinion or positive comment on that post. So that IT company will tell to the political party leader that you are going in the right direction, your image is good among the public on the basis of the data. This is the world of data science, guys. Small, small activities we are doing, and because of our activities, companies are generating the business and everything. Other thing as well. Have you ever observed this? Okay, when you are downloading any app, after downloading the app, that app is asking you this permission. Please allow us to share your gallery. Please allow us to share your contact. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
At that time, what we people are doing?
Allowing.
Happily, we are allowing. Yes or no?
Yes.
So yes. See, imagine we are giving our valuable data free of cost to the companies. And that companies are using your data free of cost, and but they are making the money, we are not getting anything. So it is not wrong to say that we are all responsible. We all are responsible for making the Mark Zuckerberg, Jeff Bezos as one of the richest person in the world. Do you think that we are having small contribution on that?
Yes.
A lot of contribution.
Yes, we have the contribution every day. We people are directly giving free of cost our data to Facebook or not. You all are available in Facebook or not? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And you, in your account, you are active user or Facebook active user. That means you are uploading something or not in the Facebook. Your photos, your family function. You are sharing your stories with your friends. See, I am doing this. I am doing that. And that whatever posting you are doing free of cost. But that data, which is required by the Facebook, they are using your same data for making the business. So imagine the power of data. We as a common public are giving our data free of cost. And business people are using our data for making the businesses. So you can imagine the power of data, guys. So once we got this, so up to the year of 2025, it has been estimated that every day, we all individual is going to generate combinedly 253 billion GB data. Okay, 253 billion GB data. Now to store this huge volume of data generated every day, we should require a server, powerful server to store that data. And this powerful server across the world is called as cloud computing. Have you ever heard about the word cloud computing?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So because of the data science world, cloud computing is booming. Because we are generating data, and to store the data, we should have a storage system, cloud computing. So nowadays, every country is giving the full effort to convert their hard copy data into soft copy. Every government official in the India also, they are given the project to IT companies, please convert the data available in the hard copy to soft copy. That is, bring in the cloud. Because why? Government officials, you know very well, if you visit any government office and if you are asking the data 40 years before of your grandfather, so that data is there maintained, suppose, in the register. So you can imagine the situation of that register. Okay. So this thing should not happen. Our data should not get lost after 100 years. If the register gets very dangerous situation, even the mouse can eat up the registers. Okay. So it is very necessary to bring that data into the cloud. So because of data science world, cloud computing is also booming in the market, guys. Okay. And by combining all this story, so we came to know that data is your new oil, information and the asset of the today's world. Hence, today's world is called as a data-driven world, guys. Data-driven world. Because we are living in 21st century. in the 21st century, it has been declared as an industry revolution 4.0. And the industry revolution 4.0 is nothing but the era of machine learning, data science, artificial intelligence, IoT, cyber security, blockchain, and so on. In this world we are living. So anything related to data in this world is very famous. Anything, any technology. IoT is the technology related to data, it is famous. Blockchain is the technology related to data, it is famous. Cyber security is the technology related to security and our data, famous. And no doubt, data science is the king of all. Data science, machine learning, and deep learning and AI. So this is the case, guys. This is our oil, information, and asset. And after that, this data science is impacting our day-to-day life also. How? I will let you know. Many research institutes in the world has done the research on data science and machine learning. Harvard University is one of them. So before 2 years, Harvard University has given one report after analyzing something. And that report result is data scientists will be the sexiest job of 21st century. This is the statement given by Harvard University. Similarly, India is the country very famous for outsourcing the project. We are outsourcing our project to USA, UK, Australia, Dubai, and so on. So in that country also, data science is the topmost professional. Hence, that country is also giving the project to us related to data science. That's what it has been said, that there is a shortage of skilled data science professional. Please concentrate on my word. I am talking about there is a shortage of skilled data science professional. Skilled is very important here. Otherwise, you can find out many people in the market doing data science courses, but they are not getting job. What is the reason? Skilled is not there. So we want skilled manpower. So skilled manpower is always a shortage. And I would like to request you to become a skilled data science professional, not a data science professional. Are you getting my point? Skilled and normal thing is having the huge difference. So I would request you to become always a skilled person. And hence, because of this reason, data science is extremely famous. And now how it is impacting our day-to-day life? Every industry in the world, not a single industry left nowadays who are not using this technology. Either it is an automobile company, they are using the data science to make an artificial intelligence car, driverless car, and so on. Social media companies, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter is using this technology. Marketing companies, healthcare, traveling, credit cards, and so on. Then e-commerce company, manufacturing company, finance, transportation, and so on. And in the banking industry, data science can be used n number of ways. These are the few examples. Fraud detection, managing customer data, risk modeling. Then retail industries are using this technology. Manufacturing companies are using this technology. Insurance companies are using this technology. Telecom industries, education industries, healthcare, logistics. And these are the other industry, agricultural, space, cyber security, entertainment, and so on. By showing all this industry, what I'm trying to say you that not a single company left in the world, those who are not using this technology. Everyone is using this technology. Now the time has came for all of us. Either you belong to AI branch or not. Either you are from mechanical branch, electrical branch. Either you are doing MBA, BBA, MABA. You are going to work in future for some company. Every company is having the requirement of data science. Hence, that's what it is said that this is the first company came in the, sorry, first technology came in the market that which is having the requirement of all professional from all domain. Hence, this is the right time to learn this technology, guys. Now, if you remember one story, guys, of Nokia, up to the year 2010, Nokia was the number one brand in the mobile in the market. Yes or no? Have you heard that?
Yes, sir.
There is a monopoly of Nokia at that time. I have seen that era. You are also seen that. Okay. There was a monopoly of Nokia in the market. Android technology came in the market after that. Nokia refuses to accept Android. Other company accepted Android, and right now in our mobile, Android is there. Now, once the Nokia refuses Android, now where is the Nokia now?
Microsoft.
Okay, with the help of Microsoft, Buzz, is the Nokia is the number one brand in the market now, or having the monopoly in market?
No, sir.
No, sir. Okay, otherwise, if suppose Nokia would accepted the Android at that time, so you can imagine we people might be having the Nokia today because of its battery backup. Okay, so you can imagine the technology which is famous in the market. If you will adopt that technology, you will grow. Otherwise, you will not grow. Okay, and you can go to the YouTube after my talk today and you can see literally the CEO of Nokia company cried when they have announced that Nokia shut down. They said that we have made biggest mistake not accepting Android. Same thing is happening nowadays. The company, those who are not going to accept the data science, okay, they are going to have a loss. Hence, no company want to face a loss. They want to use this technology. That's what one dialogue is famous nowadays in the market. Data science plus X is equal to profit. In place of X, you can put anything. Data science plus automation is equal to profit. In place of X, you put banking. Data science plus banking equal to profit. Data science plus healthcare equal to profit. Data science plus entertainment equal to profit. So it is up to you. So that's what it is, very famous technology. And up to this slide, now it has been learned that what is data science? Data science is the process of finding hidden information from the huge volume of data. How we are finding the hidden information? By applying some scientific methodology on the world data. What is that scientific methodology? Combination of language knowledge, algorithm knowledge, mathematics knowledge, and the visualization knowledge. And as a professional, you have to learn this knowledge. This is the world of data science, guys. And then finally, why this technology is famous? From technical point of view, this is the interview question we are asking to the candidate. Why this technology is very famous? After my talk, or I want to ask the question after my talk also, you can do this activity, or else you are knowing or not, let me know. Anyone tell me when the machine learning introduced to the world? Year, let me know the year. In each year, in which year machine learning introduced to the world? Any guess, you can put any tukka also if you want, but let me know. I want to know your answer. What do you think? In which year machine learning introduced? Okay, which 19? 1911?
1998.
Okay. Other answer, anyone want to contribute? Anyone? Any guess?
1950.
So it's need of time.
Okay. Great. So someone has given the answer right now, 1950. So yeah, data machine learning has introduced to the world in that region, that is 1959, by the scientist called Arthur Samuel. Today is 2021. Okay, and machine learning introduced to the world in the year of 1959. Then why the machine learning is famous from this last 10 years? Why not it was famous from 1959 when it is introduced to the year of 2000? Now 2010, we can say. From the last 10 years, machine learning is booming in the market. And in the India, it came before 5 to 6 years, very famously. Otherwise, it was there, but was not famous like this today. What is the reason? Does you have any idea?
Sir, at the time when it was introduced, there were no number of users to consume it. But nowadays, there is a increase in the number of users.
Okay, very good.
And hardware support is also increased nowadays.
Very good. Excellent. Both have given the very good answer. So let's see the answer. Very good. I must appreciate both of you. The answer, you are related to the same. Because of these four reasons, data science is very famous nowadays. But why it was not famous in the year of 1959? Because of this reason. Today, we are having easily availability of data. As he said, number of users are more today. On the single click, we can generate huge volume of data. Or via any activity, not only on the internet, we can offline also generating the huge volume of data.
today we are having powerful computer system, as he said, hardware system. Very good. Today we are having the powerful computer systems. And here we are talking about powerful computer system, guys.
In two terms we are talking. Powerful memory and the powerful processors. Okay? Today we are having powerful processor, TPU, GPU capacity. And memory also we are having 1 TB hard disk minimum we are having right now. Then we are having third powerful algorithms. That is machine learning and deep learning world. And the fourth, we are having open source software tool. Because of these four reasons, data science is very famous nowadays. Even though you people can open a startup because it does not require many things. Because of the point number four, you people can become a startup. Now, open source software tool means what, guys? Anyone want to share? What do you mean by open source software tool?
We can make the changes accordingly.
Anyone.
That means you can contribute to that tool. Yes.
It is publicly available.
Yes, yes. Publicly available. You can contribute to that tool. Yes or no?
Yes,
very
sir.
Good. Yeah. So you can think. And secondly, it is free of cost. Python language is a open source language. You can download free of cost. You can work on Python free of cost. You don't have to charge anything. So because of this four reason, guys, data science is very famous. And suppose you are having the knowledge of data science, you are having the powerful computer systems, and you are having some project. And just on the your laptop only, you can open your own company and startup. So this is the power of today's world, guys. Just you need have a skills, you can open your own company today also. Just you want the skill set required for that. That's it. And after that, this is the ladder, very important ladder, which I am showing to the world every time I am giving my talk. This is the step-by-step process to learn AI. Artificial intelligence is the 5-floor building. You have to go to the topmost floor, 5th floor. How you will go? You will go step-wise process. You will not bring a helicopter and directly jump on the 5th floor. That is shortcut technique, wrong process. Instead of go via this process, first learn. That is called as the first floor, the floor of languages. Many languages available in the market, that is Python, R, Java, MATLAB, C, C++, and so on. Why I have written here Python? Because Python is one of the easy language in the world, dominant language in the data science community, and one of the most favorite language. And majority of the job opening, 80% of the market of job opening related to Python in the world of AI. After learning Python, in the second floor, you are going to learn data analysis using Python. That is data cleaning. Once you clean the data, the output of data science, that is a clean data, you are giving to input of machine learning. Machine learning required the input of data science, clean data. Then machine learning, you are applying the algorithm to the data. Algorithm will learn from the data. Then after that, machine learning is used for the prediction. But there are certain drawbacks of machine learning, which is overcome by the deep learning. Deep learning is the world of neural network. And after learning the deep learning, door of AI will open. So in this way, you have to follow the sequence. If you will follow this sequence, then only quality learning will be there, otherwise not. After this, this is the relationship between AI, ML, and DL. AI is the bigger umbrella. Machine learning is the subset of AI. And the deep learning is the subset of machine learning. So as I said, I am having the habit of teaching that technology from the word also. So artificial intelligence, two word, artificial and intelligence. Break the artificial intelligence into two part, artificial and intelligence. What is our duty in company? Our duty in the company is that provide the intelligence to the machine artificially. That is artificial intelligence. Or in the other word, we can say that we have to make intelligent machine which behave like human. Or which mimic like human, that is AI. Machine learning. Break the machine learning into two part, machine and learning. What do you mean by machine, guys? Machine means what? Hello? Yeah, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Machine, say anything, guys. Express your views. Expressing the views.
So any device capable of doing work.
Okay, that is a machine. Okay, So see, computer is one of the machine. Alexa is one of the machine. Sophia robot, one of the machine. Drone, one of the machine. Washing machine, AC at your home, refrigerator is the machine. So all these machines nowadays are coming with the AI capabilities. So all these machines are learning actually. Machine learning, break the machine learning into two parts, machine and learning. So these are all machines. And all these machines are learning from what? Can anyone guess from what they are learning?
From data.
Very good. Simple answer, data. That's what the world is, data science. All these machines are learning from data. Similarly, in the deep learning, break the deep learning into two parts, deep and learning. Deep means neural networks. All these neural networks are learning from the data. That is a relationship between machine learning, deep learning, and AI, guys. So AI is the process to make an intelligent machine. Machine learning means learn from the data and ready for the prediction. Same with deep learning, learn from the data and ready for the prediction. So these are the final actual process. That data science is majorly used for finding the insight from the data, cleaning of the data. That clean data we are giving to machine learning and deep learning team, they are applying the algorithm to the data so that algorithm learn for the data and they are ready for the predictions. And that prediction we are giving to the AI team, which are converting the prediction into actions to make an intelligent machine. So see the sequence. First data science, then machine learning, deep learning, and then AI. If you will directly jump into learning machine learning, deep learning without learning data science, is called as a dangerous attempt. Don't do that. Follow the sequence. There is no shortcut. Follow this sequence. And after knowing this, okay, if you will search in the Google, what are the top technical skills in the world, top 10, you will always find machine learning, deep learning, data science on the top of the chart. Similarly, if you will Google it, top 10 programming language of the world, you will find Python is always majority of the chart. So why I am showing these two slides to you? Because you people are the smart student. Okay, I believe that nowadays students are very smart. They are knowing everything about how to use the gadgets. So, but the students are confused majority of time what to make a career. That means how to make my career in a very good way so that you can earn a good amount of money. As the starting of session, this thing motivates you, good salary. So majority confusion is there. So this is a simple answer to you people. Okay. The answer is that always learn the demanding technology of the world. That means the technology which is demand in the market, learn that. You will be in demand. And when you will be in demand, you will be at the greater salary. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Or either if your replacements are available in such a way that what you know is known by lakh student also parallel in the market. So you will not get a good salary. So always remember, guys, learn the recent demanding technology of the world. You will be in the demand. Always try to keep yourself in demand. The secondary factor will automatically come. What is that secondary factor? Salary package automatically come. They will run behind you. So do this, guys. And as I've taken this step of selecting the AI as a branches is the one step for that. You already chosen that step, learning the demanding skills of the world. Now second step, what you have to do right now, upgrading your skills. That's it. And then you will see the fruitful result in your final year. And right now also you will get, I will let you know what, how you will get that. Now, most important slide of our presentation is this project flow in the company. Whenever we are doing any project in the company, so this is the flow we are following. Concentrate everyone, extremely important sequence. This you should know as a student, because by knowing this slide in your mind, you will have a better planning in future. So concentrate. Assume that we are, all of you are the employee of one machine learning company. Company has given one project to us. That project name is lung cancer detection using machine learning algorithm. That is our project name. Lung cancer detection or prediction using machine learning algorithm. Now this is the project given to us and we are an employee. So what is the first step in any company? That is, this is called as a problem statement, project name. Now very first step is data requirement. we will think, all of you, we will have a meeting together. What is the data required to complete this project? So we came to know lung cancer patient data is required because we are solving that project, lung cancer patient detection. After knowing this data, then we will do a data collection. Now here I want to ask this question, from where we will get the lung cancer patient data?
Hospitals.
And any other source from where we will get?
Hospital from testing labs.
Very good. Pathology lab, testing lab.
Pharmacies.
Okay, great. Now one
government
question.
Government record.
Okay, government record. Very good. Now one question to all of you. Suppose tomorrow I will send any one of the student, those who are listening here, to the one of the biggest hospital in the Pune. Go there and bring the cancer patient data. So you will go to that hospital. So will the hospital will give the data to you?
No.
No, they will say who you are. Okay. So imagine no one will give the data to you. So because it is a confidential data. So instead of that, company and hospital will have an agreement first. Okay, MOU first, legal agreement. Then only they will share their data. So here, first of all, there is a legal agreement between our company and the data providers. And after that, we are going ahead for the data collection. And in this slide, there are the three blocks, block number A, B, C. Block number A is called as a big data engineering. And this team is having the responsibility of collecting the data related to project from the different sources with the help of different tools. So big data engineering is going to collect the data related to project from different sources with the help of different tools. And that tools are called as SQL, Hadoop or Spark. And this team is called as a big data engineering. Why big data? They are collecting the data in huge amount. And after collecting the data, they will keep the data in database, that is server. Once you kept this data as a server, then this output of A is given to the B. So see, output of A is given to B block. Now in the B block, first team is the data science team. First team is a data science team. Okay. And this data science team, now we are learning this. See the data science. Okay. We are learning this data science, machine learning, deep learning and AI. Now this team will read the data from database of the company with the help of Python language, and they will analyze the data, visualize the data, and interpret the data. That is data cleaning. And they are going to give this clean data to machine learning team in the block number B. Machine learning and deep learning team will apply the algorithm. Algorithm will learn from the data. Output of the algorithm is a model. So see, output of part number B is a model. So this sequence we are following in the company. Data science team is majorly responsible for cleaning the data. Machine learning, deep learning team majorly responsible for applying the algorithm. And output of algorithm is always a model. And this model is having the hidden information. That is whether the patient is having cancer or not. So we are checking that. After testing that model n number of times in our computer system, and we are satisfied now model is working good, then that model we are bringing and giving to the society with the help of deployment team in the form of either website or mobile app. That means we are converting the model either in the mobile app or website format with the help of deployment, cloud computing team. Imagine we have converted our model in mobile app. So that app will be available in the Play Store, cancer detection. Common public will download that app. After downloading that app, app will ask some input. You have given the input to that app. Okay. And that app will give the output that you are not having cancer. In this way, from starting to end, we are working in the company. And at every state, we required a data science professional for the job purpose. Every stage, part number A required a professional. Part number B, first part data science required a professional. Part number B, second part required a data science professional. Part number C required a data science professional. And by combining all, that is the biggest person who knows A, B, C both, A, B, C and all these three. He is the main demandable person with higher package. So you can imagine, step by step job available. So the first team is a big data engineering team.
What is the responsibility? Collection of the data related to project from different sources with the help of different tools. At number B, responsibility, analyzing the data, interpreting the data and visualizing the data. Visualization we can do with the help of this, observing the graph, either with the help of Python or either with the help of Tableau or Power BI. Okay, and in the Tableau or Power BI also huge jobs are there. If you don't know the data science world, forget about that, learn Tableau and get a job. That is also the possibility. So this is the data visualization, guys. And after data visualization, this slide is very important. Data science is the extremely important backbone of the data science industry. Okay, backbone of the data science industry. So in this backbone, 70% to 80% of time in the data science is given to data cleaning. More you will clean the data, more qualitatively machine will learn. Okay, more qualitatively machine will learn. So this is the process, guys. Okay, this is the process. Okay, now machine learning required a quality input. And what is that quality input? Clean data. And to bring a clean data, 70% to 80% time we are spending here. Converting raw data, unstructured data to structure. Okay, this is the process. And after this, okay, as I said, machine learning required quality input to give quality output. That is the famous dialogue in the company. Other dialogue is also famous. Garbage input gives garbage output. So your responsibility is to give the quality input as a data science team to the machine learning team, quality input. After that, output of machine learning is a model. That model we are giving to deployment team to deploy the model. Okay, that is in terms of real-time application, either website or app. After knowing all this, this is the time spent in the life of data scientists, guys. Many people think that data scientists are creating the model. No. Actually, data scientist is having so many types of responsibility. Understanding the project, that is problem statement. Understanding the data requirement and data collection. Cleaning the data. Applying and generating the models. Checking the models and tell the story. This is the reality. And after this, this diagram, you will get multiple diagram in the internet. But the flow, data science flow, workflow is same in every diagram. Only diagram changes, but the flow will be same. What is this flow? You will collect the data related to project first and store in the database. Then you will do the data cleaning. Then you will apply modeling. Then after that, you are going for prediction. This diagram and this diagram is same. Okay, that means diagrammatically it is different, but the flow is same. First of all, you will collect the data, then clean the data, then apply the model to the clean data, then test that model, evaluate that model, and then go for the prediction. This is the process. And this diagram is also same. That is, flow is same. Discovery means what? Collecting the data related to project. Okay, this one. Data preparation means what? Data cleaning. Model planning and model building means what? Applying the algorithm to the data, clean data. Output of algorithm is a model. That model you are going to check, that is operation, it is working good or not. If it is working good, go for communicating result with the stakeholder. This is the process, guys. So discovery means what? Collecting the data related to project, data preparation, cleaning of the data, model planning, model building means what? Applying the algorithm. Operationalize means what? Check the data and communicate the result with the stakeholder. This is the process. Then finally, this is the main diagram. Starting to end, raw data of project give to data science team. They will clean the data. Clean data give to machine learning team. They will create a model by applying the algorithm to the data. And that model you are giving to the deployment team for converting the model into real-time application. So this is the extremely important slide again,
which is showing the all history of data science. After knowing this, when you will recruit in the company, you are going to do this kind of analysis. When the company will give you data for analysis, they will ask what happened in the data, tell us. So that is called as a descriptive analysis. Then they will ask that why did it happen, that is called as diagnostic analysis. Then how could it happen, what could it happen in future, that is called as a predictive analysis, machine learning world. How to make it happen, that is prescriptive analysis. And what to do, why to do, and how to do, cognitive analysis. So these are the analysis we are doing in the company. Descriptive, what happened. diagnostic, why did it happen? Predictive, what will happen in future? How to make it happen? Prescriptive, that is recommendation. Cognitive, what to do, why to do, and how to do. This is the process. And then finally, evaluation of tools is going on in the company every day. Today we are learning Python language. Who knows, after 3 years, one new language will come. The necessity of new language will come in the market to learn that. So always keep updated your personality and skill set related to recent tools. After that, this is the skill set required to learn data science. You should have the knowledge of mathematics. You should have the knowledge of machine learning algorithm and deep learning architecture. You should have the knowledge of computer science. Computer science does not mean computer science branch. Here, computer science means one language only. That's it. Then you should have the knowledge of data cleaning and all. Domain expertise, which is written here, is optional. For example, we are applying this data science to medical project. We are not a doctor, guys. We don't know the domain knowledge of that. So domain knowledge is optional now, but above that, all is compulsory. That is, you should know the mathematics, statistics, visualization knowledge, then machine learning and deep learning architecture knowledge. And after that only you should go ahead. So please remember that my five ladder building. After learning Python, you have to learn data science packages. So these are the data science library packages, pandas, scipy, numpy, and so on. After learning these data science packages and mathematics, you are going to learn machine learning. Today my talk is on data science, not on machine learning. Hence I am just showing this slide for example. These are the four different types of machine learning: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, semi-supervised learning, and reinforcement. If you want to know brief in machine learning, you can organize our talk separately. I can focus more on machine learning in that talk. So now I'm skipping the machine learning because today's topic is data science. After learning machine learning, then you are going to learn the deep learning, this one. Again, if you are having the interest to learn deep learning, organize my another separate talk for deep learning. I can give the knowledge of deep learning world. So this is the process, guys. And once deep learning you will learn, then door of AI will open. That is the types of AI. Artificial intelligence is having these three types. Very interesting slide, guys, all of you. Artificial weak intelligence, then artificial strong intelligence, and super intelligence. So guys, what is this? So please remember, what is AI? To make an intelligent machine. So after making intelligent machine, we are comparing machine intelligence with the human intelligence. So we came to know many things. We came to know that machine intelligence are far ahead than human intelligence in faster mathematical calculation, in memory capacity. We humans cannot remember 100 mobile number, where machine can. Similarly, human intelligence are far ahead than machine intelligence in many categories. Human intelligence can feel the emotions where machine cannot. Human intelligence can feel the taste of food where machine cannot, and so many categories. So after the final comparison between human intelligence and machine intelligence, human intelligence win the race. That kind of intelligence is called as artificial narrow or weak intelligence. And our world is going through this phase right now, artificial narrow intelligence. Second is artificial strong intelligence. Scientists are optimistic. They are saying that one day will come where there will be a machine available which can beat the human intelligence or is equal to human intelligence. That is a strong intelligence. And third, dangerous one, artificial super intelligence. Many Hollywood movies you have watched that. A day will come where machine intelligence will surpasses human intelligence. That is the types of AI. And after this, what is data science now? Actually, this is my view. I have written in this way. Data science is an art of finding hidden information from the huge volume of data and then go for the prediction from that data, that is AI and ML world, and then converting that prediction into actions, that is AI. So data science is an art, and you people have to become an artist. And to become an artist, you should have the tools, the hatiyar, like weapons, we can say, resources to apply on data. And what is the tools and hatiyar? This is the tools and hatiyar. You should have the knowledge of language, that is a Python language. Then you should have the data science packages knowledge, then mathematics knowledge, then visualization knowledge, then machine learning knowledge, deep learning knowledge, cloud computing knowledge. This is all written in this slide, tools required for that. Okay, if you are having all this tools knowledge plus this mathematics knowledge, statistics, probability, linear algebra and calculus, this four chapter, then you will be able to get this job in the company. This one, data scientist, machine learning engineer, NLP engineer, computer vision engineer and so on. So these are the job role you will get in the company: data engineer, data analyst, machine learning scientist and data scientist. And please remember this flow of my that ABC block. Block number A is a big data engineering. So the person who will recruit in the big data engineering team is called as data engineer. Data engineer is having which responsibility? Collecting the data and storage the data. And for that purpose, you should know SQL, Hadoop, Spark, Python and cloud computing. That's it. Here, if you are not having algorithm knowledge also, it's okay. Then data analyst. Once the data is collected, then role of data analyst will start. The main responsibility of data analyst is to clean the data, explore the data. And after that, clean the data, it is giving the data to machine learning team. And for to become a data analyst, you should have the knowledge of mathematics, Python and data visualization. That's it. And then machine learning scientists should have the knowledge of all algorithm of machine learning and deep learning. It will apply the algorithm to the data for learning and do the prediction. And finally, main person is the main hero of the picture is data scientist, who knows how to find the hidden information, how to increase the business, how to present the data in front of stakeholder, what is happening in the overall process mathematically. So this is the case, guys. And once this has been done, this is the overall team in the sequence. First, data engineer is required, then data analyst, machine learning scientist, and data scientist. This is the process. And after this, these are the other designation, that is statistician. Data administrator is for data security. Business analyst is the person who are communicating between the company and the client. So this is all the designation you will get. And finally, once you recruit in the company, you are going to make us these applications. That is AI in healthcare. You are going to make a project for us, that is speech recognition. Okay. Then robotics industry. If you recruit in the robotics industry, you will make this product for us. Okay. That is applying the AI to the machine. Then robotics industry, same, Boston Dynamic robot. Then translation industries, one language to another. Instance vision translation, one image in other language, you are making AI product to read that image in your language. Then automatic driverless car you are going to make. Transportation company called Uber and Ola are using this technology. Food company Zomato and Swiggy are using this technology. There are thousands of application, lack of application, I have highlighted few one. And after this, finally, what are the challenges of this technology? These are the challenges. Up to this slide, it is very clear to all of you that we are learning the data science. And to work on the data science technology, quality data is the first priority. Hence, in the company, we are not getting the quality data related to project. Second, we are not getting skilled data science professional. This is the challenge. Third, startup management companies are not providing the financial support to data science team for R&D project. Many a time in the company, we are having difficulty of accessing the data. Then data science is not effectively used by the stakeholders for taking the decision. Privacy issues. Many a time domain knowledge expert is not there. Hence, these are the challenges we are facing in the company, guys. And after knowing these challenges, then how to make a career in this field, learn all this necessary skill set, machine learning, deep learning and AI, apply in this all industries, wherever you want, you will get a job. Okay. So what is the takeaway of today's webinar, guys? The takeaway is this diagram we came to know. Whenever the project is given to us, that is called as a business objective. After that, we are doing the data requirement. After data requirement, then we are going for data collection. Once the data is collected, then we will do the data cleaning, EDA. After that data cleaning, we will apply the model, that is algorithm, to the data. That is a model. We will get output of algorithm as a model. Test that model, evaluate that. If it is working properly, deploy that model and do the monitoring. This is the process of data science. This you learn, this diagram you learn, give the raw data to data science team. They will clean the data. Clean data given to machine learning team, they will apply the algorithm. And output of the algorithm is model. Then that model we are giving to deployment team. This we came to know. Then we came to know that data science is the field of finding hidden information from the data. How we are finding? With the combination of language, mathematics, visualization and algorithm. Then we came to know the different job roles, skill set, application and the challenges. So that we all came to know. So finally guys, as I said, I have observed many students across the world. They want a shortcut technique to learn any technology. So this is not possible. If you are expecting to learn high-end technology within less amount of time, so you will not able to do that. Instead of that, suppose you are expecting this shortcut technique, then doing the rocket science project and writing in your resume and applying for a job, wrong process. Don't do that. Instead of that, do this smart approach. Learn any technology without any time constraint. Learn the basics of that technology. That is, if you are learning data science, learn mathematics behind the scene. Then do the baby step project. That is a small project. Then do the case study, participate in hackathon, internship, and you can make your profile very strong and then apply for a job. Okay, and do the internship as well. Then finally, you will be able to get a job. So that's all about from my end, guys. If you want to reach me out, you can reach me out in this contact information any time. I will be very happy to help you out. Now I am open for the doubt solving session. You can ask me any kind of doubt. This is my contact information. You can reach me out here. Yeah, am I audible?
Sir, not a doubt. I know something. So there's a documentary on Netflix called The Social Dilemma.
Okay.
It is explained properly. That means how AI and data science means combinedly how company earns, like Google, YouTube, Facebook. Okay. It earns with the help of data science and artificial intelligence. It's means usme bahut acche se dikhaya gaya hai.
Yes,
it is explained very properly.
That's what I want to say, that data science is having the huge potential. Wherever data will be there, guys, okay? So data science and machine learning is applicable, okay? Data science and machine learning is applicable. So you are saying about the social dilemma. There are many things in the Netflix product which are used in the recommendation systems, okay? This Netflix, Amazon, Sony Live, okay, now OTT platforms are available, OTT. And this OTT platform is having the huge competition with each another. So you can have a good career in this OTT also, OTT companies. And this OTT platform majorly using the recommendation machine learning system.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So you people can reach me out at this contact information. I'm available on the WhatsApp also on same number. No worry. But you can ask me the doubt related to anything. Either you can connect me in LinkedIn. You can ask the doubt related to internship or career. If you are not understanding anything, you can connect with us. Don't worry about that.
So aapne koi courses kiye kya? Had you done any courses for data science?
Yeah, many. I have explained in my introduction also. I have done during my learning phase of the life of this data science and machine learning. I have done 70 plus certification. More than that, I'm writing the figure which I know. I know that more than that I have done. I have done the 70 plus certifications in the world of data science, machine learning, deep learning and AI. I have done so many certifications from other universities as well, outside India and so on. But certification is one of the way of improving skills. Certification won't give you guarantee for a job. Certification is the way of improving skills, okay? Because we have seen so many candidate, okay? I also, during my initial phase of the interviews in my, after learning, I got rejected in company after doing the certifications as well. Certification won't give you guarantee of job. Certification is one of the ways of improving the skill set. Getting? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Job will given by your skills. If one person is there, those who had not done a single certification also, but the skill set is huge. He knows everything or she knows everything. Company will give that job. If one person has done the more than 100 certification also, but no skills, no job. So I'm not saying that don't do certification, because certification will help us to improve our skills. Getting, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now you can ask the doubt, guys, if you are having the doubt.
So you will talk about startups, Riga. Yes, sir.
Yes. New so people.
Is there any platform for means new startup ideas to get investment or to get
ideas? Ideas, no one will going to help you, because from the ideas only other person are making the business. Idea you have to generate.
No, so ideas. So I'm not idea. I mean platform. Okay. Like if I had an idea, but I don't have that much money to implement. So you have any idea that about any platform that are available for students to participate for regarding startup and can get funding?
There are so many competition occurring in India as a startup competition, we can say. You can present your idea in that platform. But once we came to know that this platform is having one drawback. Actually, what is happening? Many investors, those don't have any idea, are sitting there. And you are presenting idea in front of them and they are rejecting your idea. But at the end of the day, you will come to know after some time they have implemented your ideas. So this is one drawback, guys, opening your ideas in front of everyone. But I can say one thing, that you can start your work as a freelancer if you are having any ideas. Instead of depending on any investor, you start as a freelancer initially doing the small projects. And at that time, then you can register your idea first in form of one company and everything. And then you can reach up to the angel investor to invest the money. This will be the right process. And another one is the Upwork, guys. Upwork, I don't know you heard about this or not. This is the number one famous freelancing website across the world. Here, if you are having the skill set, directly you people will get attached with the company. No mediator. Suppose right now you people are selected in Infosys company. Infosys company will hire you at a 6 lakhs per annum job. But the Infosys company has taken the project from other client, State Bank of India. And Infosys company has given the project of State Bank of India to you. But you are working under Infosys. Infosys company is asking you to solve the project of SBI. On what thing? The skill set which you know. Suppose AI project. Then you will do a job day and night for the Infosys. They are going to only pay 6 lakhs of total lineup. Okay. But they are going to make you the work of 1 crore also. But they are paying you 6 lakh. So that is a drawback of actually working somewhere else. But as a freelancer, what you can do, as a freelancer, you and directly SBI will be in contact. No Infosys in middle. I'm just saying one example. Okay. You and SBI is in contact. Okay. Now you only deal with the SBI to do this work. I'm going to. And this is the life of freelancer. Many talented professional, those who know, those who believe in their talent, is working as a freelancer nowadays, because they know they are going to earn the huge volume of money via freelancer, either working under someone else. Are you getting my point, what I am trying to say? Because in Bangalore, Hyderabad, nowadays students are learning. They are not yet pass out. They are learning, earning the huge amount of money via this Upwork.
Yes, sir. Understand.
Understood. So that's what I am focusing you guys. This is the world of a smart student. That traditional process has gone. That in campus will come, I will participate in campus. That traditional process, you know, that traditional process, guys. I will prepare for the campus. Then we will sit in the campus. I will get rejected. Again, I will sit in, I will get selected. Then I will go via company. Now, this also you are going to follow right now. Okay. This traditional process, obviously. But other than traditional process, this facility you can avail of becoming a freelancer. No one can stop you. Before pass out only, earn the money. And even during the interview, this they will give the huge package also. Got it, everyone?
Okay, sir.
Yes. So feel free to contact me anytime. Even though I will do one thing that, yes, Priyanka ma'am is here. Priyanka ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, I am going to share one link with you after my talk. Okay. So please pass this link to the students so that they can become a member of our data science community. There they will get the information of job, means certification programs, internship, the recent technologies or thing going in the data science world. Okay.
Yes, sure.
So you can become a part of our community student. Okay. Join that group today. We are going to prepare two groups. That means one is on Instagram and one is on WhatsApp. Both are same group, but platform will be different. Join both. So I hope that you people enjoyed the session, guys. I hope.
Everyone, please turn on your cameras for session photo.
Any doubt, guys? I hope you have enjoyed the session. Let me know how you enjoyed or not. So that in near
future. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Great to know. So thanks everyone. If suppose there is no more doubt. So then Priyanka ma'am, can we wind up the session if there is no more doubt?
Yeah, sure. Everyone, please turn on your cameras for session photos. Thank you so much, Arpit sir, for this wonderful session on behalf of AISSMS Institute of Engineering and Technology and entire fraternity. Yes, I would like to extend my special thanks to our HOD Dr. S.V. Limkar sir and Principal Dr. P.B. Mane sir for their constant support and guidance. Last but not least, I would like to thank all the audiences for their active participation in this event.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Okay, so I will give one link, ma'am. Pass out to the students.
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Thanks.
Feedback form link for this session is shared in the chat box.